Hey, I'm Andy with Tennis Warehouse, and today we're gonna learn how to hit a serve. The serve is arguably the most important stroke in tennis. It starts every point, and when used correctly, it can give you a tactical advantage in the point. I'm gonna highlight the five key elements that every high-level serve should have. First, it's very important that you're serving with a continental grip. Many people, when they start out playing tennis, use their forehand grip to serve. This is called the frying pan grip or the pancake grip. And people can produce some pretty effective serves with it, but it's gonna limit how good and consistent your serve can be. If you watch the pros, every player is serving with a continental grip. The easiest way to find your continental grip is to take the racket in your opposite hand, like so. Take the V of your dominant hand and work it down the beam of the racket, all the way down to the grip, and that should be your continental grip. This should be the way that you would hold a hammer, and the V of your hand should rest on the left bevel of the grip. This is the most universally used grip in tennis. Next, the tempo of your serve is very important. You always want to think slow to fast. So when I'm starting my serve, I want to start very calm and balanced, and you want to start with a ritual that you can repeat every single time you serve. And what that's going to do is help you get focused and balanced before every serve. For example, I like to bounce the ball 7 times before my first serve and 3 times before my second serve. And I want to do so with my feet lined up so that if I were to draw a line from my back foot and to my front foot, it would point at the net post in front of me. So remember, think slow to fast, calm, still, and balanced at the beginning, and fast and explosive up into your contact. Next, I want to get to the most important aspect of the serve, which is the toss. A consistent toss will lead to a consistent serve, while an inconsistent toss will lead to an inconsistent serve. Start with your arms straight. It doesn't have to be locked out like that, but just nice and comfortable there, with the ball in the tips of your fingers. And what you're going to want to do is just place the ball up above you instead of flinging it out of your hands. You don't want that ball to spin as you're tossing. Toss location is also extremely important for your serve. It may vary slightly from player to player, also depending on what type of serve that you're hitting. But a general rule of thumb, if you picture me and the position of the toss as like a clock, you want to be tossing right at that 12 o'clock position directly above you. Some people may move their serves, their toss slightly to the right for a flat or a slice serve, or slightly to the left for a kick serve, but generally you want to be right around that 12 o'clock range. Your toss height should be not too high, but not too low. Your toss should be high enough to allow you to not have to rush your motion and get fully extended for your contact position. Yet you don't want it too high to where the ball is falling more than a foot or two from the apex of the toss. Any higher than that, where the ball drops a few feet from its highest point, your toss may be too high. After you toss the ball, you're going to want to move yourself into a loading position, getting ready to explode up into the ball. And it's important here that we remember our slow to fast tempo. We want our energy to build during our motion. As you do so, your left arm should still be fully extended from your toss. That's going to help keep your left side of your body up. And your knees should be bent, ready to explode up into the ball. With your legs, they can be one of two ways here to do it. Neither way is right or wrong. They're both widely used on the pro tour. You've got guys like Roger Federer or Pete Sampras that use a platform stance where their feet are still apart, their weight is evenly balanced between their two feet, and they're going to jump up into the ball without moving their feet. Other guys like John Isner, Rafa Nadal, myself actually, use more of a step-up stance. So I may start a little bit wider at first and then step up into my loading position. Now my feet are together, my knees are together. Once again, my weight is balanced evenly between the two legs and I'm ready to explode up into the ball. So your knees are nice and bent, you're ready to explode up into the ball, your left arm is extended, and now the position of your racket is extremely crucial here. So with that left arm up, you want your racket to be really close to your face right here. And what that's gonna do, you wanna get your, kind of in a position where you would throw a baseball or a football if you didn't have a racket in your hand, kind of right by your face there. And what that's gonna allow you to do is really generate lots of racket head speed up into the ball. The most commonly taught mistake here is to get into that loading position with your racket scratching your back. okay? And you'll eventually get to that point, but you don't want to load to there because now you've got no momentum up end of the ball and you can't generate racket head speed. You want that racket right here so that as you explode up, you're gonna drop the racket and generate racket head speed up into your contact. Finally, we're ready to explode up into the ball for contact. You're in your loading position, and now this is gonna be the fastest part of your motion as you go up into the ball. Your arms are gonna exchange positions now, so your left arm will drop into your chest, your right arm should be loose and explosive, your wrist should be very loose, and right at your contact point at the top, you're gonna wanna get a nice wrist snap down into the court. One thing that's also extremely important, you want to make sure your eyes are up at contact and you want to try to see the ball actually make contact with the strings. As you're at full extension with your arms there to reach up at contact, your legs should explode up into the ball and into the court. That's very important. You want to get your body going into the court as opposed to behind you. When you do so, you're going to explode up, land on that front leg there, and your back leg will kick up behind you, and that's gonna kinda counterbalance you, make sure I'm really balanced. From that point, you're gonna wanna recover quickly and get back into your ready position as quick as you can for your next shot. And that's the basics of the serve. Be sure to check out our YouTube channel for more Tennis Warehouse Academy videos for more helpful tips. Thanks for watching.